Christmas. Are you all ready?
Yes.
Amy is. Of course Amy is. Okay. Before we get into our announcements, we have something really, really important to tell you. And so we're going to head the service up with it. If you'll direct your attention back to the organ, do you all see the green balloon? Okay, we're going to find out what that's all about. You're on, Debbie. Please give her a microphone. Or come up here.
Okay, I'll come up here. Sorry.
This is big.
Well, when you have a girl, you have a pink balloon. When you have a boy, you have a blue balloon. My husband has a kidney. So we have a green balloon. Doing what kidneys are supposed to do on his own, so he's coming along quite well. I just want to thank everybody for your prayers.
I think we can all call that a miracle because Dave was kind of feeling hopeless, and so when there is no hope, as we found out in our Bible study lesson last Monday, when there is hope, no hope, that's when God steps in, and He does the impossible, and the impossible is something only God can do. So we are grateful for that kidney, but we must remember, someone died so that David could have a kidney. And so this morning, we want to remember his family, her family, whoever they are. So we need to be praying for them this week. There will be putting a loved one to rest, and so somewhere there is a grieving family, and so we need to also keep that in our mind. To the announcements, coats for kids. If you would like to purchase a coat for a child this winter, you can do that through Keystone Coats for Kids. Also, there is going to be trunk or treat at three different churches in our co-op, Leisure Run, Oak Ridge, and Fairmont City. So if you would like to participate in that, either by taking your children or by donating, you can do that. Today, at the Presbyterian Church, there's going to be a film about voices from the valley. And those are people from our very own valley who fought in World War II. I think it's just World War II. And they're going to tell their story. So I think that will be really interesting to see. Bill, would you like to tell us something about the next adventure for the Barbershoppers?
We're going to be hosting a murder mystery dinner on Saturday, November 21st at the St. Catholic
18th.
At the St. Charles Catholic Social Hall. Tickets are available from any of the Barbershoppers. So see any guys in the choir or myself. We can get you tickets. It's $20 a person. That includes the meal and the interactive dinner theater. It'll be a very fun evening, a nice, fun night of entertainment and food.
And these are professional actors.
Yes, they're coming in from Pittsburgh. It's a troupe coming in from Pittsburgh area to do the show. It's not the Barbershoppers going in there. We're kind of sponsoring it. We're partnering with the food pantry. And we're asking you to bring non-perishable food items that will be donated to the food pantry. And each item that you bring, you'll receive one ticket for our Chinese auction items that we have available. So we'll bring lots of items to the food pantry as well.
Okay, thank you, Bill. Turning the page, please be careful when you leave the church to make sure the door is locked. Nancy Reese is having a party on Tuesday. If you can make that party, please RSVP her. The blood drive, that will be on Friday. It's important to give blood if you can. On the back of your bulletin, please keep in mind that at 9:30 every morning, we will be meeting on the third floor, and we will be doing a prayer walk because we want the Sunday school rooms to be filled. David Green is an example of how prayer works. So we believe that if we pray diligently, that God will put in front of us people that we can invite to church. We don't want families from other We want families who are unchurched. So please join us at 9:30 every Sunday morning. Bible study tomorrow night. Charge conference. Very important that you all here tonight for charge conference. 7 o'clock. This is an important business meeting for our church. And you are all a part of it. So be here tonight for charge conference. Tuesday, food pantry. Thursday, the 19th, men's prayer breakfast. Saturday, Alyssa Cooper Sandy will be at Fairmont City. If you haven't heard her speak, it's a real treat. She's an amazing woman. October 24th, they'll be going to the Need Community Cafe in Kensington. Prayer vigil on Thursday, the 26th, important part of our monthly meetings. Dollar dinner, this coming Thursday, right? 19th. Pork and sauerkraut. If you don't come to a dollar dinner, please start. It's a great time of fellowship, and it's a great time to support the church. Jane, do you need any cupcakes? That's Joe. 9 cakes. Do you want them iced? Okay. We need 9 iced cakes. Please run to Joe after church and tell her you'll bake one. Okay, missions, I don't know. Do we have a meeting on the 24th, Joe?
Pardon?
Missions on the 24th? Mission meeting?
I'm not sure about that.
Okay, that's pending. Yeah. All right, are there any other announcements?
Yes.
Yes.
Unity Cantata practice starts this afternoon at 2 o'clock at the Church of God Reimersburg.
2 o'clock today, Community Cantata, Reimersburg Church of God.
Practice.
Yeah, practice. There's lots of practice, yeah. Okay, there's one more? I'm sorry, Amy.
No youth tonight because of charge conference.
Okay, no youth tonight. Because we had so many announcements, please just look at the person next to you and say, kiss, kiss, hug, hug, and we'll move straight into, Guy, Joel, stop it. We'll move straight into the first praise hymn, page 2140. Please stand.
Jesus came into my heart.
O merciful God, be gracious and bless us, for we are unworthy servants of yours. God, help us to make known your ways all upon the earth. Let us make known your saving power, so all those who hear can praise you. For upon this earth you have yielded our increase. May you always continue to bless us, and may we revere you forever. Please turn in your bulletin to the prayer of confession and join with me. Merciful God, from you comes all truth, all healing, all that makes our world good and whole. Forgive us, O Lord, those times when we have listened to those who do not speak for you. Forgive us for the weakness that has led us at times to seek the water of life at springs which can never satisfy. Forgive us for not testing the spirits that are around us. Forgive us, too, for how we play with empty knowledge and delight in useless predictions that help neither us nor those around us. Have mercy on us and speak once again to us. Help us to hear and spread the word you send and to
stand in front of 251 in our hymn. The unsaved, Grace Miller, fire victims, Ken Kramer, and the Kim McAfee's family. Do we have any joys today?
Happy birthday.
Yes. Remember Jeff and Nancy Brocious.
Deb Gruber.
Lynn Pearl.
Shirley and Jerry Sawyer. Jerry just got out of the hospital on Thursday, and Shirley just seems to be able to adapt to it, to whatever. She's having a rough time.
Shirley and Jerry Sawyer. Roxanne. Yes, please keep praying for Dave. He's not out of the clear yet.
And then we have to go back every day.
They have been watching for a while for certain things. So keep praying for Dave.
Red Dinger.
Any others? Red Dinger.
Just have a procedure on Tuesday.
Dan McLean family. Let's go to prayer. Gracious and Heavenly Father, we do thank you for this day. We thank you for all the blessings that you bestow on us each and every day in every one of our lives. Father, we thank you for this beautiful day you created for us, and to be able to come here in this building, join together with our church family, and sing praises to you and worship you. Father, we thank you for how you interact in our lives and how you have answered prayer in our lives and throughout our communities. And Father, we especially thank you for the celebration of another birthday. And Father, we thank you for being able to get together, the ladies of the church, and come together and have a program and a tea. And we just give you praise for the success on that evening. It's so good to be in your house, Lord, and we just